The only thing that would prevent that from happening is if the cost of doing that is too high. And so my view is the first thing is that we should help Taiwan not to win an all-out conflict against China, that's not possible, but to have the capability to raise the cost of military adventurism there to a level that China is not willing to pay.
Sounds like to me as if Taiwan may be the flashpoint in U.S.-China relations, the one place where our vital interests might clash in some way. Does that, how do you look at the Taiwan issue?
Well, it's a tricky situation. Obviously, the Chinese position within Taiwan has eroded, as you saw in the recent elections in Taiwan. Clearly, those who oppose being linked to the mainland have grown both in prominence and in political strength. At the same time as the U.S. has become more assertive in its relations with Taiwan, sending now two high-ranking officials there in the last month and a half. And you've seen sort of an uptick in Chinese air incursions into the air defense zone sort of as a messaging exercise. I do believe that eventually it is a red line issue for China. And eventually, if necessary, they will move if by force, if necessary, to sort of exert what their claims on Taiwan. And in many ways, what we've seen them do in Hong Kong is sort of a test for that in the sense that they ideally want it to be. They would love to have political figures in Taiwan that manipulate the existing system to make that happen, but they're prepared, as they were in Hong Kong, to send in forces if necessary. The only thing that would prevent that from happening is if the cost of doing that is too high. And so my view is the first thing is that we should help Taiwan not to win an all-out conflict against China, that's not possible, but to have the capability to raise the cost of military adventurism there to a level that China is not willing to pay, and that navigate that very carefully with an effort not to sort of try to trigger a conflict like that from happening. And that's, I think, the best hope that we have at this point in managing that relationship. But it's a very difficult one. It's a challenging and tricky one. And I do think we have to navigate it very carefully and not be overly provocative, but also not be provocative in the reverse by almost inviting a Chinese action there at some point here in the next decade.
民主自由我们会全力以赴我们做最坏的打算但是我们会完成最好的准备要放弃我想问一下关于栗战书今天早上对台独有提出说将会采取一些必要手段包括非核武的方式我想中共的谈话我们都看到了实际上区域情势的变化国军都一直在掌握这个里面最重要的中共他一直不放弃武力犯台 这是一直以来他的一个政策那么台海从年初到现在他们也做了八次实施军事威慑针对性的一些活动跟训练我想这都感觉到看得到所以也因此使台海区域的情势疫区严峻我想这是众所皆知的那么针对这些情势的掌握国军国防部都一直 很小心的谨慎的在掌握整个当前的情势的状况那么我想我们也会做好各方面的一些应处透过勤鞭针然后做一个情势跟侦后目前状况都没有异常或者特殊我想我们国军会坚守国土主权坚守民主自由我们会全力以赴
我们做最坏的打算但是我们会完成最好的准备大家放心不想问一下吴钊燮他之前提出下一步啊就是这样可能会针对台湾那这个说法之前有个知会过国防部然后这样的说法会觉得说会更激化两岸关系
我想外交部他们都做了很多说明啊那部长有部长的一些理则跟考量啊在外交部比较他们都做了说明我想我们国军国防部这一块就刚跟大家报告啊非常谢谢大家
之前没有知会
之前没有知会你这个跟国军、跟国防部这边说话，会不会有国外的人士说大陆下一步可能会？
我想武力犯台，就刚刚我讲啊，这一直以来都是
中共的一些在军事威慑上面，哎，军事形势上面它的一个表现啊，就是武力犯台一些它的一些行动啊，都是有啊，这军事形势都是有的。我想外交部他们做了说的。
部长在朱日和基地好像有总统府跟外交部的那个模型。
我想那是训练的基地的哈，就是他的手段只是他的构想，那他的构想就是刚刚跟大家报告，他一直不放弃武力犯台，所以在各方面这些准备它是必然的。所以这个我们早就有掌握，有在掌握。谢谢，
谢谢，谢谢。